bending the rules. Oh, you think you know him? It's Edge Adam Copeland's turn. In his very own film, nonetheless, opposite Jamie Kennedy and a whole list of half-decent actors who I won't even care to name. They don't deserve to be brought up here. No. Bending the Rules comes to us by the same director as Inside Out, and somehow he's made an even more boring film with an even harder to follow plot. That is an achievement in itself. Surely that is an unlock on one of the WWE games' unbelievably complicated plot of the year. So here it is in a nutshell. Edge is a dirty cop. He takes drug money to pay for what looks like food and his incredibly bad taste in shirts. I 100% believe that when this film was pitched to Edge, he was like, yeah, I'm the ultimate opportunist. Why wouldn't I wear crazy shirts? I'll rise above. They are disgusting. Not unlike the acting by Adam Copland. He fumbles through the film like a teenager on prom night. Not quite knowing what to do, not really grasping how to get around, but wanting to look cool while doing it. Jamie Kennedy, on the other hand, might as well be 10 miles off screen, he's phoning in that much. Jamie Kennedy plays District Attorney Theo Gold. Conveniently, the man trying to prosecute Edge. The two have to team up in a crazy buddy cop film when Nick's car is stolen. His father's prized possession, Hawk. The entire storyline pivots around finding a car, and somehow it's worse than Gone in 60 Seconds. Nicolas Cage and Angelina Jolie took time in that film to compare stealing cars to having sex, and I'd watch that film over Bending the Rules any day of the week. The storyline is far, 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 far too complicated. Bending the Rules wants to be light of touch, without depth, and have a convoluted storyline you would not believe. And in the end, what happened to the car doesn't really matter. There are characters you literally do not see before the end of the movie who come out and try and kill the two protagonists. One of the major problems of the movie is that you're supposed to feel somehow annoyed at Nick for being correct and empathize with Edge for being wrong. It's not even metaphorically, but quite literally, the cool kid from school who used to smoke pot round the back and the nerdy bookworm who always did correct. One was hated, one was beloved, and it was never right. Maybe I'm a little bit bitter. Sure, maybe I am. But you know what? That kid in the library, he remembers my name. You think you know me? You think you know me? Bending the Rules reeks of awfulness.
You think you know me, think you know me, think you know me.